Eyewitness Sports right now.
For the ninth time this season, the Utica Comets are playing the Syracuse Crunch. But even though they keep playing the same team, the teams have looked a little bit different every time they've played, even if it's here in Utica or in Syracuse, because there have been roster changes throughout this entire season. And for the Comets, they've faced roster changes over the past 3 days, every single day this week. First, it started off the week with some news that goalie Mikey DiPietro would be back in Utica from the Vancouver Taxi Squad. You might remember that he started last year as a rookie for his pro career right here with the Comets as the Comets' lead goalie. Now he's finally going to be getting some game action. He hasn't played since that March 11th, 2020 game, the last time of the last game last season before the season was eventually suspended and then canceled because of the coronavirus. So he'll get some reps in is the plan, but he's not available tonight according to the Comets because he did need to complete the 3-day quarantine minimum based on the AHL rule. So he is in Utica, but we won't see him dressing this evening. Also, some other news on the St. Louis Blues side. The Blues have called up defenseman Mitch Rankey and they've sent down forward Dakota Joshua. Dakota Joshua, you'll remember last month, scored his first NHL goal in his first NHL game with the Blues. That was the only point he had with the team, though. He did play in 11 games, but now he's being sent back to Utica to play some more. You also have some amateur tryout opportunities. Four players, including a defenseman added today, a goalie, and two other forwards earlier this week that were at practice yesterday morning right here in Utica. They're getting a chance to show off their skills about what they might be able to do and how they might be able to contribute to the Comets. And head coach Trent Cole says with all these young guys on the team now and so many games over the next few days to complete the season, they might actually get some opportunities.
That'll probably be the group that actually gets on the ice more often than not. And sometimes in that situation, I'm going to say this, but it doesn't mean it's going to happen. Like, it's almost like it referred to as the black ace in the NHL. Like, these guys have come in. They're going to practice. They're going to be around the pro atmosphere. They're going to be around and see these games and learn from that. And then if called upon, you know what, they're going to get opportunities. And so that's – and part of that today was great for me to see that group in a decent practice to kind of maybe in my head see where – who might be available to us and who could maybe help our group.
The Comets' busy stretch to end the season includes 11 games in the next 19 days. That includes 7 games against the Crunch over the next 8 of the Comets' games. By the way, on the Crunch side, Syracuse goalie Samuel Montembeau has called up to the taxi squad for the Florida Panthers today. So he did pretty well, 3-3 against Utica this season, but Utica won't have to worry about him this evening. Cole also adds that most of the player development for these next few games in the busy stretch will take place during games, and then those off days they have rarely will be used for rest. But a busy schedule could mean fatigue or injury for Comets players, opening up those spots for some younger guys on the tryouts to actually fill in for the Comets down the stretch. In news of former Comets, forward Reed Boucher and his KHL team in Russia, the Vanguard Omsk, have won the KHL championship. And it's the first Gagarin Cup in franchise history for Omsk. Vanguard won the 6th game of the series today, 1-0 to win the series, 4-2. Boucher finishes the season with 65 total points through 72 total games. The regular season was 2 games shorter than last year's AHL season, so comparable. Reed Boucher this year had 19 fewer points than he did with Utica Comets in last year right here. Utica College women's lacrosse played in the Empire 8 quarterfinals last night. It was Utica's first ever home playoff game. UC hosted Cuca College. The Pioneers had just beaten the Wolves in the team's first matchup since 2015. It was 22-2 then, and Utica handled the game pretty much the same way last night. Shots were 47-10 in favor of Utica in yesterday's game. A 14-3 halftime lead for the Pioneers led to a 20-4 win. Whitesboro graduates totaled a combined 19 points in the game, led by junior Lexi Skatia with 5 goals and 2 assists. Skatia now leads the Empire 8 Conference with 42 goals this season. Samantha DeCondo has 38. Now UC advances to the semifinals. They'll play Nazareth tomorrow at 4 p.m. So for now, that's all for sports. The Utica Comets and Syracuse Crunch are on the ice against each other once again, 9 times. Call highlights for you later tonight on Eyewitness News, first at 10 on WFXV, Eyewitness News 11 on WUTR. And hey, in a few minutes, tune in to, at 6:30, WPNY, the Comets face-off pregame show on our sister station, WPNY. One click up right here on WUTR. Until then, enjoy the game, everybody. Stay friendly and stay tuned.